Back at the Eaton Center, doing a video at the fourth floor stairwell balcony. I'm gonna do a video on something that a tradition that I do that I've done for about 5 years, which is for each month of the zodiac, I choose a stone and name it to theme that month. So I'm just gonna go through the stones that I've already. I always start a new year with the month of Virgo and end with the month of Leo. So I'm just gonna go over. I've got with me here, I'll show a video clip quick of it first, of the stones that I've got up to date. It's the month of Aquarius now, as well as the stone carving that I did. I'll describe that. And I've got a stone that I also carry from the first year that I did this, as well as a silver coin. That has nothing to do with it. And one stone that I'm going to use either next year's cycle or in a future year. So these are the stones. This is one that I had. This is from the first year that I did it. This was for the month of Taurus. That's the silver coin. Canada coin from 2018, I believe. 2018. This is a carving that I did on shale. Shale is very frail, so it's easy to etch into. It's just a symbol that I like to do. Lips and a heart and an eye. I wrote a poem about it, which I've got on. That's one thing that I want to do is begin to reference poetry that I write, that I've written in the past, and even spout it. Record me saying my poetry. So this one is called, this for the future one, it's a piece of opal, an opal marble, and I call it Casper Zero. Casper for Casper the ghost, and Zero for Zero the ghost dog from Nightmare Before Christmas. I couldn't decide on either one, so I just called it both. So this one is La Vie en Rose for the month of Virgo. This one is Rose Le Renard, which translates to Pink the Wolf Fox. This is Essence of Unicorn. That's for Rose La Vie en Rose for Virgo, Rose Le Renard for Libra, Essence of Unicorn for Scorpio. This is Preserved Momentum, which I named it that because it looks like a stone that had preserved momentum in time. Usually I name them off of what the stone's kind of inspired, like either what I want them to be or what they kind of look like to me, like this. I named Fragment of the Fountain of Youth, and that's what it looks like to me. This one is for the month. Okay, so preserve momentum for Sagittarius. Fragment of the Fountain of Youth for Capricorn, and for this month of Aquarius, I've got this one's called Patience. It's been sitting in my drawer, my desk drawer at home for years now, maybe even before I did the first session of this, which was 5 years ago. This is the fifth cycle that I've done. So it's took patience to gain meaning, but it's got meaning now. And this, as well as these two alone, as well as this one, are stones that I found, including this. I guess this is from the beach, same with that one. This, I believe, I found at Blue Mountain here in Ontario. These two just in Pickering, beach in Pickering. This, I think, was found in Rouge Valley, just at the Scarborough-Pickering border. Rouge Valley Conservation Park. This one is from the States, brought home by my parents from the southern states, either Nevada or California. I think Nevada? Anyway. Store-bought. This was bought at the X. These two were bought at Laurel Caverns in Pennsylvania, I believe. And this one was bought at a gem shop in downtown Old Quebec. This one is named after someone whom I refer to as Daisy. But that's not the name of the stone, it's her actual name, the short form that she goes by, of her name. This one is Ruby Fouchette, I think I'm saying that right. Really, other than rose quartz there, and shale here, and then the opal, I don't really know the names. In this one, I don't really know the names of the types of stones that those are. But this is a fragment of the film. It's not anyway. So that'll just be my video for week 5 of this 50 Lore weekly posts. Next is the Black Currant Rhubarb monthly post, which it's the 29th today. Bell, let's talk. Let's go. Hashtag Bell, let's talk. But yeah, I only missed the 1 week where I had to mash the week 2 with 3, but it's sloppy and messy. Like a sloppy Joe, but I'm munching it up myself so as to know a better recipe to do it in the future. Till then, peace.